What's up, everyone? I am Helena Alamu, and welcome to another episode of the DNA Download, where we explain the science of genetics so you can live in the know. So I have friends who are 23andMe customers, and they've told me they're 55% Native American, 12% Italian, 2% Japanese, and so on. What does this all mean? Joining me to unpack this question is Erika Bellman, 23andMe's Ancestry content writer. Thanks for being here, Erika.
Thanks for having me, Helena.
So, Erika, can you describe what these percentages are and how they're determined?
So those are the percentages of your friend's DNA that come from different regions around the world. While some individuals have DNA that predominantly matches one single population, if they're 99.9% Scandinavian, for example, other people's ancestors come from many places. And the scientific term for this is admixture, the genetic mixing of previously separate populations.
So admixture means the mixing of separate populations. Got it. But how do you figure out where my DNA comes from if it's all sort of mixed together?
So at 23andMe, when we analyze your saliva sample, we divide your chromosomes into short pieces, kind of like boxcars in a train. These pieces are short enough that it's generally fair to assume that the DNA they contain comes from the same ancestral population. And for each of those pieces, we compare your DNA to the DNA of people whose ancestries we already know. And when we find the best match for one of your DNA boxcars, we assign it that particular ancestry.
Wow.
These results are then summarized to you as percentages in your ancestry composition report. 55% Native American, 2% Japanese, and so on.
Okay. You know, that sounds like one of those sorting games I would play as a kid, but with a genetic twist.
Yes. We group the pieces of your unknown DNA with the pieces of known reference DNA. And that's not all.
Oh, we're not done sorting?
What we can do next is compare your DNA to the DNA of 23andMe customers whose families come from that same region. If enough of your DNA exactly matches, we can confidently assign that region to you.
Wow, meaning I may have recent ancestors from that region.
Exactly.
Okay, what if someone doesn't see the results they expect? Like, if my friend knows that her family comes from Germany, but she doesn't see that country in her report.
That's a really great question, Helena. If she doesn't see a location or population that she might expect to see, that doesn't necessarily mean that she doesn't have ancestors who are from there. It can be complicated because humans migrate a lot, and country borders have definitely shifted over time.
Okay, so it's like if my friend's grandparents live near the border between Germany and Poland, so she tells people that her grandparents come from Germany, but her grandparents' DNA might look more like the DNA of people who live in Poland today.
You're totally getting it. It could also be that our database simply doesn't have enough reference individuals who come from that part of the world. Yet. But as our database continues to grow and diversify, and it's growing a lot, we may be able to give you more details about your ancestry over time, so you should keep checking back.
Wow, it's like a living analysis. This is so cool. Well, I definitely feel like I have new tools at my disposal for learning more about my family history and ancestors. Thanks again for being here with us, Erika, and see you next time on the DNA Download.